that car.
Don't say it.
But he never calls me. There he is.
I'm changing my speech. You watch.
Well, so did, have you figured it out?
How are you? Nice to see you.
Happy birthday.
See you right there. Give me a hug.
I know you've made Uppy's stay, you've made mine for sure. Thanks for your presence, and we have your attendance, that's what I meant.
Sounds the same. Your presence
is being fed. Anyway, we're going to start off with... No, we're going to have a lot of entertainment. I'd like to introduce you to some of the people. Many, I would appreciate it if the honor man would give me a moment. Thank you. I'd like to introduce you all to Uppy's family. Many of you don't know his children. And I just want you guys to know who they are. In the far table over there is Robert, the oldest one. I don't see Caroline.
No.
Is she there?
No.
Oh, no.
Then Helen lives in Vancouver. And then there's Jim, who's going around taking pictures or doing some audio work. There's Jim standing there. And then there's Anita and her partner, Brian. And the grandchildren are here. Also, I'd like to introduce you to Uppy's ex-wife. She was smarter than I was. That's our view. And also, Uppy's in-laws are here, Mr. and Mrs. Beltrami. I forgot to mention Tanya, Jimmy's wife, and their son. And for the rest of you, you're all good friends and relatives and distant cousins. Uppy's brother's here with his wife. And I just want to mention that we have two couples here from a faraway land. They're our neighbors and friends from Florida. But they live in Indiana and Illinois. There's Chuck and Debbie and Karen and Nick. Also, Uppy's godchild is here. There she is, Cheryl. And where's Lawrence? Oh, sorry. Okay, so now that you kind of know who you are, if you will take 5 minutes and introduce each other, yourselves to each other around each table so you know who you are. That would be good. We'll start by, we have a lot of entertainment here tonight.
Speak up, Helen.
We got to say hello to you, buddy.
Come on. All the musicians. There's Jackie Johnson and Neil Johnson. There is Judith, where's Judith gone? Judith McBurney and Frank McBurney. And there's Michael Petrician. He's right here. And also Alicia. She's somewhere in the back there. She's going to be singing as well. So maybe we can just start off with a beautiful song from Jackie. Johnson. She has a nice repertoire. I don't know which one she's going to pick for now. Did you want that? Sure. I'd appreciate it if the guest of honor would return to his seat.
Hey, ask me how I knew my true love was true. I, of course, replied something to his side. Can I be denied? They said someday of course.
That's better. Friendship is a priceless gift. It cannot be bought or sold, but its value is far greater than a mountain made of gold. For gold is cold and lifeless. It can neither see nor hear. And in the time of trouble, it is powerless to cheer. It has no ears to listen, nor heart to understand. It cannot bring you comfort or reach out a helping hand. So when you ask God for a gift, be thankful if he sends not diamonds, pearls, or riches, but the love of real, true friends. Aww. And I thought of all of you here tonight. I thought it was just so beautiful. Okay, enjoy the food.
I'd like to have your attention for just a minute. I'm not going to take up much of your time, but Helen graciously gave me the opportunity to say a few words. I am Uppy's son, just to give it a context. Number two in order. I'm the guy with different phones. I never fall, that's right. I'm the ungrateful, evil son. And as I said to my dad, you should not have insulted me when you first walked in, because I haven't said my speech yet. So,
dear dad,
so as I said, it's an honor to speak on behalf of my siblings and myself and Daniel. My son, if you'd like to leave the room now. So growing up, where's my brother and my sister? Growing up, my dad was generous to a fault. Remember that, generous to a fault. Whenever we would order takeout, it was never just a pizza. We'd get Kentucky Fried Chicken, pizza, hamburgers, whatever we wanted. So that was a lot of fun. When he'd take us to Fort Erie or Woodbine Racetrack, I would be the runner. Imagine today they call children's aid, but back then I'd be the runner, and I would go get the tickets. He'd give me the money, and I'd go bet on the horses for him. And every time, he'd make sure I had a few bucks so that I could have my hot dog or hamburger. Again, he was generous to a fault. He helped finance the retirement funds of many a jockey. We had a lot of trips to Florida. We had a lot of fun as kids growing up. And we would, he always had nice cars, big cars, in the body shop business. And he had a Coupe de Ville, a 1976 metallic gold Coupe de Ville. And we drove down to Florida. So I was lying in the back window. Again, children's aid would be called today. I was lying in the thing at the back window. My brother was lying across the back seat. My sister was lying across the back seat sleeping. My younger sister was on the floor sleeping. My father was driving down the 401 at 120 miles an hour, racing a Porsche. My mother screaming. My dad said, "Don't worry, he's not going to be able to pull us over." Guess what? The cops pulled us over. And that retirement fund for that cop has been financed by my father, generous to a fault. Growing up, he was he still is a larger-than-life character, and that's literally. To this day, I still think that he was the model for Fred Flintstone. So, like, if you look at the profile view, keeping in mind his hair wasn't gray years back. And I used to proudly say that my dad was Fred Flintstone growing up. And I've never met a man with bigger hands or head. Years ago, when a friend of mine got into a car accident, he went to get his car fixed at my dad's body shop. And afterwards he said, "Jim, I thought I had big hands, but when your dad shook my hand, it was like he was shaking the hand of a little doll." And I like telling people, when I take his finger, for a ring from his finger, I wear it on my big toe. So right now, I'm wearing his rings on my toes. The other thing is, I remember hanging around the shop as a kid, and my father would go out and get food, clothing, and shoes, and he would literally send me out back to give food, clothing, and work boots to some poor families out back. So again, generous to a fault. So those of you that know him. And I'm sure all of you have stories to tell about my father, from whatever spectrum, both good and bad, I'm assuming, but larger than life stories. And you're all here for a very good reason, because the thing that's biggest about my father is his fart. I mean, his heart. Sorry. If you know my dad really well, both are true. So all of you here are for a reason. It's because of his big heart. I know he's hard of hearing, and I want to make sure he understands that I'm saying he has a very big heart. And he's generous to a fault. So at this time, I'd like you to all raise your glasses and give a toast. And I call it the Happy Birthday Toast. Happy Birthday Toast. So here's to Uppy and his generous heart. Cheers. Box. Cheers. There you have it.
Reminded me of Uppy and myself when we talked about who had or has the most girlfriends in their past. And one of the songs I've heard recently with Julio and yeah, the old fella there singing with them. Yeah, old Willie Nelson. So I'm going to try. I'm a shower singer, not anywhere else. I'm just going to try and sing it like Julio and Uppy being old Willie. To all the girls that were in my life, and now they're someone else's wives, I owe them all I know. I owe them all I know to all the girls I've loved before. Anyway, that was a mess. And when you smile, the world is brighter. You touch my hand and I'm a king. Your love to me, it's worth a fortune. Your kiss to me is everything. I guess I'll never know the reason why you love me as you do. That's the wonder of you. That's from the Happy Life.
Okay, now we have Jackie Johnson again, singing some of our favorites. Don't Cry For Me, Argentina will be the first one.
All you will see is the girl you once knew, although she's dressed up to the nines at sixes and sevens with you. I had to let it happen. I had to change. Couldn't stay all my life down at here, looking out of the window was staying out of the sun. So I chose freedom, running around trying everything new, but nothing impressed me at all. I never expected it to. Don't cry for me, Argentina. The truth is, I never left you. All through my wild days, my mad existence, I kept my promise. Don't keep your distance. And as for fortune, and as for fame, I never invited them in, though it seemed to me they were all I desired. They are not the solutions they promised to me. The answer was here all the time. I love you, and hope you love me.
We do.
Okay. Don't cry for me, Argentina. The truth is, I never left you. All through my wild days, my mad existence, I kept my promise. Don't keep your distance. Have I said too much? There's nothing more I can think of to say to you. But all you have to do is look at me to know that every word is true. This was another one that was one of Uppy's favorites. And it's from The Phantom of the Opera. It's called The Music of the Night. Time sharpens, heightens each sensation. Darkness stirs and wakes imagination. Silently the senses abandon their defenses. Helpless in the notes I will arrive. For I compose the music of the night. Slowly, gently, night unfolds its splendor. Grasp it, sense it, tremulous and tender. Turn your face away from the garish night of day. Turn your thoughts away from cold, unfeeling light. And listen to the music of the night.
Days. And if you know the words, please sing along. I'll do the first part in English, and the second part I translate it into Dutch, and in between we'll do the lalas. And then I want you to sing along, because in the Dutch version, there is, the way I've translated one of the lines is Je weet waarom. And so those who do not speak Dutch, I want you to say this after me, so that when I go like this, nudge, nudge, wink, wink, you say you made about home. So, deep velvet nights when we are one. Speak softly, love, so no one hears us but the sky. The words of love we share will live until we die. My life is yours, and all because you came into my life with love so softly. Now everybody go la la. La 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 la. La 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 la. Here's the Dutch. Fluent nacht, je weet waarom.
You didn't say it. You didn't say it. Okay. Je weet waarom. Je weet waarom.
Mijn verwarmd dagen verwarmd door de zon. Fluent nacht. Je weet waarom. Nookie, nookie. Spreek zacht in de straat en haal me warm tegen jouw hand. Ik voel je woord en de trillende momenten start. Jij bent van mij en altijd weer. Dat jij kwam, mijn liefdeschat zo zachtjes gaat. Mijn gekleurde dagen verwarmen door de zon. Fluwele nachten, je weet waarom. Spreek zachtjes gaat, dus niemand hoort ons, alleen de lucht. De liefde van moeder die we hebben zal blijven tot onze laatste zucht. Jij bent van mij en altijd weer. Omdat jij kwam, mijn liefdeschat, zo zachtjes gaat.
So that's the Godfather theme.
That's a little appropriate. Sometimes you're a Dutch mouth. I believe it. I
Well, I was just about to say that. This population consists of primarily Canadians, Ukrainians, and Dutch. So first of all, go ask all the Ukrainian people to stand up.
Hey, Kevin.
And now I would like all the Ukrainians to sing him Noha Yagika. One, two, three.
Noha Yagika.
It means to many years. stand up. All the Dutch people. Now I'd like you to sing Happy Birthday in Dutch. I can't help you. But I think... Okay, 1, 2, 3.
In the night of the Helen. In the glory, in the glory.
I gotta make a wish.
No, wait.
Okay.
Yay! Now we'll all have cake and coffee.
Not eating enough. Jackie.
I don't have to. One of the girls can do that, right?
There's a thing right there.
Thank you very much.
Talk to the microphone. We can't hear you.
Sitting beside me, there. You know, I'm 80 years old, and if I had known that I would get it old, I wouldn't take better care of myself, that's for sure. But the truth is, I told Helen weeks ago, I want no party, no surprises, I don't want a damn party, and don't get any ideas. And I thought I was kind of forceful of me to realize that I don't want a party. My legs are aching, and my knees are aching, and I am not mobile, and I cannot do what I want to do, and why party if you don't feel well? Well, very selfish thinking on my part, of course, but then I'm a selfish bastard.
Yeah.
Truth is, I really like, I'm such a dumb ass. I fell for it again, but they did it very smartly this time. Mary and Joe, who I don't forget this, you got something coming. They conned me in such a nice way that it all made perfect sense to me to go out for dinner and that they're going to treat me for a dinner. And I said, that's very nice. I love them both very much. But I said, don't go to the expensive place. And, you know, that's, I'm happy with Swiss Chalet and keep it down because I feel very uncomfortable when people take me out for some reason. I don't know why. It doesn't matter why. But they did it very smartly. As a matter of fact, we were in the car and I felt kind of at ease that I wasn't going to a party. And I made a joke in the car and I said to Mary, Mary, you're going to regret this. I'm going to have 3 appetizers, I'm going to drink 5 bottles of wine, and you're going to have a tent for $800-$900. I'll teach you to invite me for dinner. Then of course we come here and I walk in, I see you people. And you know what? I missed... I have really no words to express my gratitude, and I feel humbled. I mean, people here from the United States, people from Grimsby, people from everywhere, from down in the East Coast. I mean, I'm really humbled. And then I see people like Jimmy, my mechanic. Hi, Jim. You're such a gentleman. Say hello to Jim. Jimmy and his wife. Okay. Then I see a fellow at the cap there. His name is Frank, who I know for 40 years.
when in my dark days, and I used to be a little short, I'd be banging on his door on a Sunday morning, telling him I need 500, and he gives me the 500. I mean, we go back years.
Tell him what the kids say.
Excuse me, don't interrupt. Yeah, this is funny. The big guy, his son, he was an old baby. So this is maybe 40 years ago, I forget, 30 years ago, whatever. And it was a Sunday morning, and I came to the house, and he had a dog, and the dog looked at me, and he made a few, couple of them. And then the little kid ran in the house and said to Daddy, Daddy, the fat guy is here. I thought I was in shape 30 years. And he called me the fat guy, and then of course Frank gave me money. Then I look at another guy in a black shirt. Stevie, stand up for a minute. A friend, you cannot have a better friend. This guy will give me his right arm. If I tell him they give me 50,000, he gets me the 50,000 if he hasn't got it. But fortunately, he's got it. He's got about 38 horses. But what a guy. He is a true, true friend. And you know, money doesn't make a friend. But if a guy has a heart, and the right kind of heart, and stands up and is willing to give his right arm, that's a friend. And that's one of them. And we got kind of on the table, Wally, who I see there not long ago with his lovely wife. Very nice people. And it was Mom, very nice lady. I know everybody. Well, Walter, right? Walter, I can mix up with his wife. Very nice to see them. And my new friend here, can I call you my friend?
Yes.
My new friend and his lovely wife. You know, I told Helen, I told the dark, you used to look like her. Nice. Anyway. Now that's me. You still look nice. You still have a nice blue eyes. You still have nice blue eyes, and it fits your shirt, okay? And don't be, okay? You know what I told? You know what? Excuse me. You know what I told this gentleman here? I might come across a little rough, maybe. But when I was on the downside, and years ago, I told the gentleman, you can push me in the right direction to get up. So.
Don't cry.
I'm not crying. I'm just stating a fact. I'm not bullshitting. I state facts, and I think it's you deserve to deserve to be heard. And I appreciate my brother, Rudy, who asked a couple of thousand. I needed it, but he would give it to me. He said he didn't have it. He worried about it. I don't know how many men, but anyway, my good friend Peter. Stand up, Peter. Peter is my fishing buddy. We were on Lake Simcoe yesterday, and I met another guy, Jerry, who was 89. But Peter is very courteous. He comes out of the car, the first thing he does, he gets my walker, he helps me to get to the boat, helps me to get in the boat, helps me to get out of the boat. He does basically everything in the boat. Thanks, Peter. And of course, the people who I met in Florida, excuse me, Nick, can you stand for a second? Nick, where's Nick? Stand up, please. And your wife, Karen, can you stand up for me? And then the lady beside you, can you stand up for me? And the good-looking husband of yours? Okay. You know, and of course, the other gentleman who's rubbing his head. Ooh. Stand up for a minute. And your wife, please. All right. Anyway, these people are gracious. For the short time I know them, I met them in Florida. The reason I have a place in Florida is because the gentleman who's sitting down, he was so nice and gracious to invite us to stay at his place for 3 weeks. And then, of course, we had an opportunity, we bought it. But these four people there, I was there last year, was it 2 years ago, when my kid was at night? Sorry.
There goes the neighborhood.
That's okay. Anyway, they were in our place, I should say, to support me, to hold my hand, and said a few prayers. They're really true friends. And to see them here, I can't flabbergast. You know, it was the other way around. I wonder, would I go? I think so, but still.
I'd kick your butt.
Anyway, my good friend, what else? And everybody nice. This fella here. It was nice who did some work, and I worried him about, you know, not get upset with Helen because he has a lot of the edges. Anyway, it all worked out. your lovely wife who sang nicely. Your son, who is a terrific gentleman, a nice guy. My friend, who...
With a bright shirt.
Oh, you look very nice. Don't worry about the duck set, okay? There's something. Don't do that, you know. Anyway, Walter, thanks for coming. Pleasure.
Pleasure.
What are you eating? Dessert again?
Yeah.
No, not, I don't maybe. Marika, thank you. Well, I can... this is my dear son who's walking around here. You know what I call him? Don't
Tommy.
Get mad, folks. I call him a whopper.
Happy.
That's there's, nice.
Well, it's only a nice, that is not a bad word. What they did, my friends here are telling me, but what I am jealous is because he spent more time with his in-laws and just mirror with them than he ever just with me. So I said, that son of a gun, he never phones me. He, you know, blah, 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 blah. Here, he said, more like
all this time he does the video, he did all
right, but don't want you to interrupt me, please. Let's cross for divorce. But anyway, funny thing, I was sitting there and the gentleman, Jim's father-in-law, who's a very nice fellow.
Mr. Beltrami.
He's a prince, Mr. Beltrami. Uncle of Salami, whatever I mean. And his wife and his daughter is there. And he came up to me and he said to me, I like pizza. My wife, you, me, pizza. And I said, what a pizza? Oh, I think maybe he wants to invite me to his house and he makes me a pizza. That's nice. I said, okay. But he kept talking about pizza. And he did. Then I realized he wanted a picture. So I told Jim, he wants a picture. So then we had a picture. It wasn't your fault that, you know, I'm getting old. I just pissed in the street. Anyway, what can I say? I'm just great. I am honored. I am humbled. And I really mean it for you guys to be here. You know? I'm flabbergasted, really.
Our pleasure.
Yay!
Yeah. Thank you. Tell the people that performed. The lady here with her husband and son, and this other lady who sang Boogie Boogie with her boyfriend or husband, I don't know. But anyway, that was really appreciated. Thank you, thank you, thank you very much. And sorry.
Alicia.
Oh, yeah, but Alicia's family. I don't have to be nice to family, though. Alicia. Alicia, thank you very much. Thank you for coming. I know you're very busy, but you're moving back and forth. And Corey and Rudy, thank you. And Tony and Heinze, yeah. And of course, Pete's daughter. Hey, I can't go on. Steve Goods, thanks for being here. What can I say? Thank you.
Not much else to say.
Yeah, really?
You said it all.
No, you can say, get the hell out of here.
No, not me.
Oh, I don't know.